And it's World Tourism Day today, and in sharp focus is rural tourism. Let's go there now live.
South Africans to enjoy music and other forms of entertainment in a safe manner. When it all seemed gloomy and lost in the midst of the pandemic, the tourism sector did not wallow in despondency and despair. The sector stakeholders came together and worked collaboratively with government to develop innovative strategies so that the sector could operate in the new normal. Indeed, this approach paid off as we saw tourism subsectors moving at initially going to operate at level one, but started operating some at level four and actually more activities at level three of the risk-adjusted strategy, and thus began tourism's road to recovery. Ever since government opened interprovincial travel, I've been traveling across various provinces, visiting establishments and meeting with travelers and establishments owners. I'm happy to report that many of the establishments are ready to open, if not already opened. I know when I was in Tsitsikamma, many of the activities opened because I was visiting. As we left Tsitsikamma, the activities never stopped. Actually, by the Sunday as we were leaving, we received calls, for example, in the zip line that I took, that they were already fully booked for the Monday coming. This is a clear sign that South Africans were looking for leadership to show that indeed, as they go out, they will be safe as they embark on tourism activities. Across the country, South Africans are sending me messages and pictures of their tourism experiences. South Africans are taking their families and friends to adventures, for game drives, hiking, and other kinds of memorable tourism experiences that our country has to offer. After 6 months of lockdown, South Africans are going all out to rediscover the country. They've heeded the call when we said we are reintroducing South Africa to them. The vibrancy of the domestic tourism we have witnessed is in line with what our recovery plan had envisaged, which is that the recovery will happen in phases. In this regard, we predicted that the recovery will start with domestic tourism, then regional land and air markets, and lastly, presumptions of the worldwide international travel. I would like to convey my sincere appreciation to all and many South Africans who have heeded the call to get out of their houses and travel the country, helping us to save the businesses, helping us to save the jobs. In other parts of the world, domestic tourism is the pillar of the sectors and international tourism is secondary. However, in our country, it is the opposite. I'm quite confident that at the rate at which South Africans are traveling, we are well on our way to make domestic tourism the main pillar of the tourism sector, because in this way, our tourism sector will be sustainable. We are mindful that a significant portion of the supply market is geared for international tourism. So the pricing that we see is unaffordable for segments of domestic travelers. We are continuing to appeal to these markets to be innovative and to adapt their products for the needs of the local market. Incentives such as affordable rates, discounts, upgrades, and enticing packages will go a long way in getting South Africans to explore their country, the country of their birth, thus giving them a proper sense of belonging. I'm again calling on all the sector players in the private sector to collaborate with us in creating a conducive environment to entice South Africans to travel. This is an appeal to the tourism sector, because the message we get from South Africans as they go, they are limited in what they can do, they are limited in where they can stay, they are limited in where they can go. We are appealing for affordable pricing, we are pulling, perhaps like other international markets are doing, a two-tier system of pricing for both the one that attracts and deals and talks to international and the one that talks to local. I know it is possible. We can do it. South African Cabinet took a decision to open the country's borders on October 1 to most countries, which is a significant milestone in placing the sector on the irreversible path towards full recovery. We expect that travelers around the world will prefer to travel to countries that offer greater diversity of attractions so that they don't have to travel multiple countries to enjoy different activities. Despite being a long-haul travel destination, South Africa will be a preferred destination because it offers diverse tourism products in addition to the greater weather and the warmth of its people. And I know many people have been asking us to say, Minister, we hear the borders are opened on the 1st of October. We are happy about opening the borders for the continent with limited restrictions because we were excited when most of our appeal to the NCCC and Cabinet were received, well received and supported by members of Cabinet. That when people come here, let's remove the restriction of quarantine because it discourages travelers, unless if a person shows signs of being sick. All that a person has to do when they arrive at our borders is to show their certificate that I have tested and I am negative. And that's what they are required to do. So we are looking forward to quite a number of our travelers, but also to say there is a South African app that travelers, when they arrive, they can download it. And this app will help us to understand the travelers' trends. Also, able to link the travelers with our health systems if they do need such in that area. I know that others have been saying we are waiting for the list. The list will be announced by government as soon as it's available. But it's simple to follow what the list is likely to be because it's very clear in terms of what government has said, is that countries with high rate of infections, countries with health system that is in trouble, whereby individuals are not able to access that, are likely to have been missed and therefore ending up in our country. And I know that some of the tourism sector people have said to us, remove all the restriction in terms of all the countries, allow everybody to come with a certificate of 72 hours. As we said in our address previously, one step at a time. That's my feedback. One step at a time allows us to analyze and be able to deal with mitigating factors. We are able to say when we face challenges, we are able to deal with them. So the step that will open the doors and the borders on the 1st of October will allow us to assess and understand the risk. We continue on the balancing act between lives and livelihoods. While we're saving livelihoods, we should not compromise the health of South Africans. Now, the countries that will be coming will allow us every 2 weeks to assess. As Cabinet has announced, every 2 weeks after the announcement of the list, that list will be adjusted. We'll contribute as tourism sector and tourism department and as tourism minister to the discussion and looking and analyzing those countries to be able to give a clear indication of some of the activities. But we are believing that we are definitely on the road to recovery. The African market has not been fully explored by us as a country. If you look at the West African countries, some of them currently it's an opportunity for us. Markets such as Nigeria, Ghana, who most of the time travel to London for shopping, can be diverted to South Africa for the same purpose. All we have to do is to be aggressive in our marketing. All we have to do is to speak to their needs and be able to convince them that South Africa indeed is a place where they can come. And obviously, my message to South Africans is that when they come here, it is not time to call them names. It is not time to treat them differently. They're here contributing to the economy. They're here contributing to the jobs of our brothers, our sisters, our neighbors, our children. So it's important to remember, as Africa will be growing, as our work grows, the continent in terms of travelers to the country, from where we're sitting, just not only in numbers, but also the spend that we're likely to see, we need to be mindful of treating them well. Similarly, with our key source markets that continue, in terms of your Europe, in terms of your Americas, and potential key source market that has potential for us to grow, the Asian market, we'll continue to monitor. As I said previously, when we look in terms of the potential of the Asian markets, we currently, for example, we do not even source 1% of Chinese market. And that will be our driver, to be able to get those travelers for those from those countries to come to South Africa. As they come to the country, let us still remember that we don't want to go back to where we were previously, where we find our travelers being attacked, our travelers being robbed, our travelers being mugged. We've seen the pain of not having tourists in our country. We've seen the pain of our brothers and sisters not working because tourism has come to a standstill. Let's remember, when travelers come here, they contribute to the work, they contribute to the businesses, they contribute to our economy, they contribute to our livelihood. So it is important for us to treat them well. As we work towards the road, and as we work towards recovery as a country, and as I said and committed earlier, that I will be in the forefront leading to showcase that it is safe to travel. One of the things that we've got to remember is that as we look across, we see the infrastructure that is needed to be able to build the economy that we want. Tourism remains a key economic driver of our country, a pillar of the economic development. It is for this reason as well that we have adopted the United Nations World Tourism Organization theme for 2020, which is tourism and rural development. It is the theme that celebrates the sector's unique ability to drive economic development and provide opportunities outside of big cities, including those communities that would otherwise be left behind. Tourism is one of the rare sectors that is able to penetrate and change communities that do not have any economic activity to becoming economically active. In his speech in April 21st, President Cyril Ramaphosa said the following, amongst other things, I quote, "The pandemic requires an economic response that is equal to the scale of the disruption it is causing. We will forge a compact for radical economic transformation that makes cities, towns, villages, and rural areas vibrant centers of economic activity," unquote. We believe that tourism will be the key driver of the overall recovery of the South African economy. The recovery that we envisage has to be inclusive, not only by bringing rural communities into the mainstream economy, but also ensuring that vulnerable groups such as youth, women, and people with disability are given the opportunity to be actively involved in rebuilding their country. Characterized by low barriers to entry for entrepreneurship, tourism for vulnerable groups is a huge business opportunity and creation of jobs. While Tourism Day Today 2020 also highlights the important role tourism plays in preserving and promoting culture and heritage all around the world, South Africa is a country that is rich in diversity in terms of race, culture, languages, and heritage. The Tourism Month in our country coincide, as I said earlier, with the Heritage Months. So we celebrate our diversity in terms of culture. That's why you can see in terms of my dress code. But also, what we celebrate is our heritage sites that are part of our diverse tourism destinations that the country has to offer. Our heritage sites are a good driver for both domestic and international tourism. The cradle of humankind tells a universal story of the origin of humanity and human evolution, both in scientific and social and cultural terms, thus making this site where we are a heritage site of the human species as a whole. It is an attraction for a traveler, domestic and international, who are interested in understanding the origin of humanity. Along with other attractions around the country, the cradle of humankind is ready to receive visitors. Indeed, as part of the recovery, it will be critical for us to focus on protecting and rejuvenating supply side of the market. The public and the private sector will have to find ways of working together to ensure business continuity. Aligning the value chain to new biosecurity standards, as well as investment facilitation and market access. The rising domestic demand, which will soon be augmented by the international market when we open the borders, will have to be met by sufficient supply side infrastructure. This is a very critical element of our road to recovery. That's why we went and opened an infrastructure project in the Big Hole. And in the coming weeks, we'll be opening other infrastructure investments that we have done as the Department of Tourism under our projects of working for tourism, EPWP projects. With the risk of the virus spread on a downward trend, South Africa is arguably amongst the safest tourism destination in the world. We are hopeful that South Africans will continue to social distance, wear their masks, and take all necessary precautions to protect themselves so that we can continue to reduce the spread of the virus. It is not yet Uhuru. Before and during these times of the pandemic, there are South Africans who, through their exceptional talents, continue to take to the world what is good about our country. Accordingly, I would like to pay a special tribute to the men and women of this country who have distinguished themselves in sports, entertainment, science, technology, and innovation, and other spheres of life, who have been raising the country's flag high. These are our country's ambassadors who make brand South Africa soar to greater heights every time they do what they do best. And this, we really want to take this opportunity to thank them so that they continue to do what they are doing. Because it is through them that many people across the globe are introduced to South Africa. Ladies and gentlemen, music has a unique ability to connect people. It has the ability to transcend borders, cultures, languages, and any other barrier that artificially divides people. It is for this reason that we've joined hands this year with DJ Black Coffee, with Master KG, with Busiso, who have brought their melodies sounds today to help us celebrate this World Tourism Day in a different way and in style. This is our way of sending a message to the rest of the world in the language they best understand, that South Africa is ready to welcome travelers from the rest of the world to its shores. Who better to send these messages than the country's biggest musical ambassadors? Let us protect ourselves. I remind you, let's wear our masks every time, not optionally. Let us wash our hands and sanitize, because through this, we will continue to grow our tourism sector. And now, ladies and gentlemen, would like to welcome Master KG on stage and request all of you to join me as we take up the challenge by President Ramaphosa to do the Jerusalem dance for tourism. And this, ladies and gentlemen, it's our way of saying to South Africa and the world, Happy World Tourism Day. Thank you.
I'm going to ask all of you to please stand up. This is not just going to be a show, you're going to be involved in the show. Make sure that you maintain your social distancing. We don't just have Master KG, we've also got the vocalist here today for the song. So we welcome them on stage, and we're gonna get a little bit of help with dancers up here. If you two have two left feet, even better. Remember, what happens in Marubeng stays in Marubeng. Before we start, can I ask all of you to please make your way to the front, as many of you to the front, so we can capture all of you in the front. Wear your masks, everybody. Come to the front. Please have your masks on. Don't be shy. Join it.
Well, as we wait for Master KG to kick into gear, it looks like the Minister of Tourism is also lining up to do the Jerusalem Challenge. It's indeed World Tourism Day today. And you know what? It comes at the back of South Africa, the world, going through a crisis, a health crisis.
Are you ready?
That is of COVID-19. Let's just listen in.
Hi, you're not convincing me. Hey. Are you ready to dance, everybody? If you don't know what you're doing, just do aerobics. It is also qualifies. Just, you know, go with the flow. It's okay. Okay. Take it away.
Are you guys ready? Master KG. Master KG.